Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Well, really, welcome to the new year. It's 2023, and why not start with Scarlet Hollow? I am the Outback Owl.
I'm Yin and Young.
I'm Chibi Noob.
I'm Jiren Cosplay.
And I'm Cozy.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year.
I'm sure we said that at some other point earlier, but, you know, whatever.
It's good to say it again.
Yeah. All right, so we're back with Scarlet Hollow. We went through a recap and we talked to some animals, which is always an excellent way to start any new year. If you haven't talked to an animal yet, do so. But what else should we do? I think we were heading down a path full of omens of ill fate.
Oh, we just found Avery.
Yeah. Yep. There they are. And look at all the giant fetus monsters.
One.
Yeah.
Two,
the one three, on the left looks very
four.
Phallic.
I hope Tabitha got some rest too. How is she? Oh God, yeah. We always end on a hey, remember what you did, because you have to choose something. She's back at work.
She is already back at work.
Yeah, I wish she hadn't stopped me. I feel so bad for her. She paid a very long overdue debt. She deserves a kind of, well, we're not doing that. If I hadn't stepped forward, it would have done, yeah. I think the top ones, because we want to be less dick, then...
Oh, wait. Know. If you scroll down some more.
To be the biggest dick, remain silent?
No, I can't believe how unfair that whole thing was.
Less dick in the new year.
It is kind of unfair. Sins of the great-grandmother, or something like that.
I can't believe how unfair that whole thing was. Neither of us should have taken on that kind of burden.
At least it wasn't you. That would have been extra unfair. From what Winnie's told me, you and your mom were totally cut off from the family, and meanwhile Tabitha owns basically the whole town. But I agree, that old guy really needed to learn how to let stuff go. Revenge is always unsatisfying. He could have been at peace anytime he wanted, but instead he let himself marinate in anger for, like, decades.
Yes, but he was so tender at that point when you marinate.
That's a lot of time wasted. He could have spent chilling in the afterlife. Straight smart. Oh, flirt? We can flirt?
Flirt? You don't have to put on a front. Last night was a lot. I get it. You were coming up to see me. That's sweet. There's ditchlings everywhere now, even though it's daytime. How you doing? Have you heard anything about Stella?
How you doing?
We gotta do some of these explore options, and we definitely gotta do a street smarts. Always do street smarts.
Street smarts.
You don't have to put on a front. Last night was a lot. I get it.
I appreciate the concern, but I'm all right. You're talking to an expert at vibing.
Ah, they're high.
Probably. I know most folks would probably be freaking out or having some kind of existential crisis, but that's not how I deal with heavy stuff.
Oh, I thought you were going to say heavy puff. Surprisingly enough, Avery is mostly telling the truth. They're fine.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think Avery's probably pretty good at processing stuff like this.
I'm sorry, all I can see now is the fact that they're wearing a Bane coat.
True! I mean, I'm not 100% chill today, I'll admit. I feel kind of bruised, both physically and spiritually, if that makes sense.
He has no chill!
Yeah, I feel a little grossed out.
But that's just part of life, right? Nobody makes it to the end completely unscathed. And I'm glad my new emotional baggage comes from a ghost instead of some boring normal trauma. The supernatural angle takes the edge off a bit.
You were coming up to see me. That's sweet. It's ditchlings. How you doing? I mean, do we want to talk the ditchlings? I don't know. Okay, real question, because we're getting more flirt options. Who are we going for?
Oh no. Can we go for everyone, or is that not an option?
I don't know.
I would think we could just get on a route. I don't know if there is, like, we can get multiple people.
Mm-hmm. This doesn't feel like a dating sim.
Yeah.
Feels a lot more like a supernatural horror story. visual novel.
Also, we're leaving in like 2 days.
That doesn't mean we can't have a good night.
Are we?
The bedroom gets lonely and we're worried about that doll. Protect us?
We're worried
about that doll.
Here's the thing.
The doll's creepy.
Here's the thing. We are worried about the ditchlings, so let's at least get like a move on some of these things.
True.
Yeah, I'm more concerned about Dustin and him getting it kicked out.
Oh, we can't do that in front of Dustin.
Yes.
He's too ditchling. Pure.
Oh, yeah.
And his mom is there.
Mm-hmm. Well,
we didn't clear out the greenhouse.
I'd like to point out, Dustin's mom is a mom. She knows what's up.
Dustin would be so embarrassed.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. I'm not worried about Dustin's mom. I'm worried about Dustin.
If we did it in front of his mom with him there, he would be so embarrassed.
Okay, like, I didn't think about the combination. All right, fine, whatever. Avery turns to survey the tree line. I don't see anything at all.
I noticed a few on my way up. They're kind of funny, now that I'm getting a good look at them. With their scrunched up little Sharpay faces.
Donk.
Not funny haha, like funny yikes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, should I be worried about these things? I know they're a bad omen or something, but like, are they dangerous?
Not unless you try to shoot them.
They're not going to eat me if I take a wrong turn, right?
Nope.
No, but they might get you pregnant. No, but they might get some eggs laid in your skin.
You're right.
They're pretty small. We might be safe. I don't know. They
not
might.
If you eat not them, eat them first.
I'd rather not find out. Does anyone in town have a flamethrower? I mean, honestly, the option should be put out there. Yeah, I mean, they might lay eggs in your skin.
My whole thing is that we already know that they won't do anything to humans unless they are personally attacked.
Yeah.
So I don't know why that's not an option.
Well,
yeah, it is a little weird, but I guess we don't trust Sybil.
We were chased by them.
Have ever been personally victimized?
We were chased by them only because we had a dog.
Yeah, but that dog is a person. Let's be real here, and they were going to attack it.
I think we don't trust Sybil at this point.
I'm fine with Sybil.
Like, we're on... No, I mean, in-game context.
I don't know
because
about that.
Because we did just get a big bomb dropped on us that she does know what's going on. And she's just not telling us.
And she says, I mean, we're going to be... It ultimately doesn't matter. Let's just move on from this.
No.
I am moving on.
But you might get some eggs laid in your skin.
Oh, is that all they do? That doesn't sound too bad. I think I could survive a parasitic larva or two.
Okay.
Just glad being eaten alive isn't on the table.
We didn't say what the larva did. I mean, is getting a parasite like that really any different than being eaten alive? They're still eating you, just more slowly and from the inside.
Okay.
What?
You got a point.
It sounds like you're saying you'd enjoy the experience. Is it terrible to say it would be kind of neat to grow a weird little guy? I would much rather be eaten.
Yes.
I get it. Being eaten sounds really bad. That's a weird thing to say. Remain silent.
I don't think it makes a difference.
That's a weird thing to say.
What?
What?
Why is the top one an explore option?
Because I guess we can explore.
Do we want to?
I don't know, it would continue the conversation. We could learn some more.
I mean, I want to continue the conversation.
I really don't know. I don't know what this person knows. I don't know what anyone knows. I'm looking for any options that give us more information about our situation so we can make informed decisions moving forward.
Debating with Avery about semantics.
Okay. Then.
What?
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 You don't agree? That's fine. To each their own.
Wait, why do they seem serious now?
But I'm the kind of person who wouldn't mind giving a couple weird little creatures warm places to pupate. if I have it to spare.
We're not flirting with Avery anymore.
Yeah, this is weird. This
Avery's is weird. An alien fucker.
Yeah, they sell stuff for this.
And if they don't kill me.
No, we're not flirting.
That was weird.
Her anything from Stella?
Yeah, that's really that's like, relevant. Yeah. That's relevant.
I feel like we just found out how he's doing, how they're doing today.
We don't need to know more about what they're
doing. So, yeah, we're good on that.
Stella!
Have you heard anything from Stella?
I haven't heard anything from her, though we don't text much, and I haven't checked with Winnie to see if she came in for an early breakfast or anything. Mm. But if you haven't heard from her, that doesn't sound great. Seeing her like that last night was awful. She's usually so unflappable.
Kanika and I are meeting up to look for Stella. Want to come?
Yeah, we should do that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Kanika and I are meeting up to look for Stella. Want to come?
Absolutely. I told Winnie I'd be coming in late today, so I've got time. I don't know how much time, though. From what I saw this morning, there's already a few minors already holed up in there.
Are the other parents with them?
They must be using it as home base for the strike. Mm. Oh, by the way, there's a strike going on.
No shit.
I'm sure you already know that, though. Have to imagine Tabitha would have told you this morning.
You know what? Wow, we totally didn't know that.
Right.
Let's head to town.
Yeah, let's go. Yeah.
Let's head to town.
Yeah, good idea.
Captain Obvious.
You and Avery start back
extraordinaire.
Down the path to town.
Here we go.
All that way.
Kanika! Oh, look at her outfit!
Aww.
They're non-binary. Monster fucking is very common in the non-binary computer.
You're right.
Anyway, it isn't long until you once again find yourself on the main street of Scarlet Hollow.
She looks so cute.
She's a brain cell.
She does.
You made it. And you picked up an Avery along the way. Hope you're both doing okay, like, emotionally.
We're not talking about it.
A wild Avery appeared.
Yeah, I'm not too bad.
That's good. I feel like I got crushed by a steamroller or something. Joints all out of whack, totally exhausted, super foggy.
We could crush her like a steamroller if you want. You know what? I feel like I put myself very much in the Stella camp, but Kanika's looking good today.
Kanika's the best.
Oh, I like that belt.
It's the moon.
Yeah. It's the moon phases.
Yeah, she's got hot very witch witchy. Vibes.
Like, she's got hot witch vibes, and she's practical. Like, she makes the smartest decisions of everyone.
She's got no nails on her special
hands. Kanika
realizes
she's in a horror game.
Yeah, she's ready to get the fuck out when things get bad.
Nor the fuck in.
She had the hidden cube.
That's true.
She knows what's up. Mom's been insisting I caught a cold and I wasn't buying it, but as of this morning, I've come around. It's definitely something beyond exhaustion, even considering the ridiculous, stressful week we've all had. But I'm not gonna let that stop me from looking for Stella.
You still think there should be a rational explanation for all this? Is someone manning the general store while we go looking for Stella?
Who cares?
So basically everyone's robbing the place. I was kind of surprised you reached out to me after all the issue between you and Tabitha. I'm supposed to see your mom at some point today. Maybe she'll finally shed some light on things.
That one.
Let's not dawdle. I'm worried about Stella, and I don't feel right to do anything that isn't actively looking for her. Are y'all sure we need to go looking for Stella? She's a grown woman. She's allowed to be by herself if she wants. She's probably okay. Just dealing with complicated emotions. Let's not forget that Wayne threatened her last night. You don't think he actually followed through on that, do you? Remain silent. Well, we're not a dick,
that
so we won't
remain silent.
That last
explore.
Which one's the last one?
About Sybil.
Here's the thing. That eventually does lead us to where we need to go. I'm wondering if that's going to remove some of our other explore options.
Are any of the others true?
The other explore options kind of sound dickish.
How so?
Okay, do you still think there could be a rational explanation for all of this? That's, like, kind of harping
okay, a
on
little
her,
bit.
Like,
yeah.
You were wrong, I was right.
The general
store's
kind of whatever.
General store?
That's whatever.
And then, like, yeah, I feel I'm like surprised have... you actually talked to me.
Yeah, that's no, that's not I really mean, a thing. We have our I... own relationships outside of Tabitha.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, but that's also just kind of a thing, like, you think maybe you overstepped your bounds and you feel kind of bad. But that's just me. Because that's how I would interpret that text.
I don't know. If you feel like we should, like, just go straight to the point, then we can get to the point.
I mean, yeah. We could skip all the explore and just go. Oh. I'm supposed to see your mom at some point today. Maybe she'll finally shed some light on things.
I'm not sure what she's planning to tell you today that she couldn't have told all of us last night.
Oh, you don't get to know Kanika.
Maybe she's gonna read your fortune.
Ooh. Dal Doom. Holy crap, 3 towers in a row. I've never seen anyone do that. There's only one in the deck.
After last night, I wouldn't doubt that she actually could. Your mom's always having a bit of that Glinda vibe going for her.
Oh, you mean like she seems nice, but really she's trying to force you into political assassination?
Yeah, honestly, I think she is that vibe.
Okay, I need to clear something up because I actually did find out something about that. Apparently in the book, Glinda is not the person she meets when she first gets to Oz. It's a different witch who doesn't know about the slippers. And then Glinda, when she meets her at the end, knows about it. But I think the production is just like, we don't want to pay for a second person. Probably. We'll just make them the same person and then just cause a whole bunch of, like, plot problems later.
Yep. They condense down that book quite a bit.
Yeah, but that one makes Glinda seem specifically, like, kind of evil.
I mean, my whole thing is like, if you, I don't know, if you have ever seen the musical The Wiz, they actually do have that other witch at the very beginning.
I kind of remember the one with Michael Jackson.
The Wiz was really good. I think it was better than the regular Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, maybe I should stop making fun of her whole New Age mystic thing. What's happened in the last couple days?
Why do you make fun of her for the New Age mystic thing? I feel like you're kind of, like, getting to that aesthetic as well.
Maybe it's just an aesthetic for her.
Mm. Yeah, I think it might be. Because she's very... There's got to be a rational explanation for everything.
She doesn't seem to believe in the spooky stuff.
She's just goth.
Yeah.
Ugh, I need to take a page out of Stella's book and just block this shit out. I need to be focused. I can't keep having all these existential crises.
Crises.
Merry Chrysler.
Merry Chrysler.
There'll be plenty of time for tea after we found Stella.
Blah, blah. Yeah,
I feel like we've gotten past some of these with just that statement. Well, let's not dawdle.
Let's not dawdle.
Let's not dawdle. I'm worried about Stella, and it doesn't feel right to be doing anything that has...
Okay, maybe that was a little bit dickish. I should have read through that a little bit.
That isn't actively looking for her.
Agreed. Let's get to work. We're too first.
Okay, maybe it wasn't as dickish as I thought. Let's go to Stella's house. We should go to the cops. We should check in on Oscar. He's smart. Maybe he'll know what to do. Let's check out the diner. We should go to the mines. We should go check out the church. Let Avery know what you and Kanika can take it from here. I mean...
Maybe we should check out the church because that one guy knows something.
Okay, but that's not the first place I would go. The first place to look for Stella is at Stella's house.
I guess, yeah.
Same. Yeah.
Fair. We can go to the cops. Just we trust them. The church.
Okay, let's go to Stella's house then.
Good place to start. Maybe she just slept in.
That's what I'm hoping. I would have gone already, but I was kind of nervous about doing anything by myself today. Just in case I ran into yet another horror from Beyond the Veil or whatever.
You should come up to our house.
Ooh.
You make your way towards Stella's house.
Knock, knock.
Kanika knocks anxiously on the door.
Ooh, she's a little bitch.
Oh, it opened, what?
It creaks open. This doesn't look like a break-in. It looks like somebody left the door open. Stella or someone else was in a hurry when they left. I know a break-in. I've done a few. She's dead. Stella died. It's all my fault. No. I'm not from around here. Is it normal for people to leave their doors open? Okay. Yeah, I would ask.
Yeah.
Yep.
Some towns are like that.
Yeah.
I'm not from around here. Is it normal for people to leave their doors open like that?
I've left my patio door open on occasion, usually when I'm home. But I've had squirrels take that as an invitation one too many times, and bust-ins take a few bites out of my plants, so even I keep my doors closed. It's bad enough that they go after everything in the community garden, but to come into my house and help themselves to my precious leafy babies, the squirrels of Scarlet Hollow are my only true enemies.
Ah, so that's why Avery's cool with the ditchlings.
Yep.
Yeah.
There
you don't
is.
Eat my plants, I ain't got no problems with you.
And Stella would definitely know better than to leave her door wide open like this, especially during the ditchling, especially considering the ditchling situation.
It's especially during ditchling season.
Yeah.
It's ditchling season.
Might as well invite ourselves in, right?
We should go in. Screw going in there. Let's go get the cops. Yeah, well, let's go in.
Oh, and cops. We trust them.
No.
I got a phone call from the cops today. They were like, hey, do you want to give us money? I was like, no.
No.
Like, oh, okay.
Yeah, we should go in.
Cool. I'll be brave and go first.
Thank you. And we never saw them again.
Bye, Avery.
Is that the church?
House. All the way in the distance.
It's so far away. Maybe it's just a perspective thing. Maybe she got like a little fairy garden.
Mm. Maybe.
She would, wouldn't she?
Yeah.
Oh, it's cute.
Oh, look, Gretchen. Her little pillow seat.
Whatever happened to Stella, it doesn't look like it happened here.
Those are her shoes, though.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't look like there was a struggle or anything. Unless it happened in another room. Or maybe someone, or something, caught her off guard.
You didn't have to add that last part. I'm just going to forget you said that and just be thankful that this doesn't look like a crime scene.
Yet.
Kitchen.
Investigate the kitchen. Investigate Stella's room. Okay, I don't think we're going to find much else here. Let's...
Kitchen.
Can we read all of them? I don't think let's move on or leave.
Should probably go to the kitchen.
You know, that would be a good idea that we should do next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey, thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe and ring the bell icon for notifications. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like, and feel free to check out some of our other gaming videos, our weekly podcast, Anime Yay or Nay, or our parody series, Madoka Magically Abridged. See you next time!